the rise of white nationalism, the rise of white fascism in the United States is a response to something. It's a response to the exact same thing that is happening in Europe, particularly on the continent, but also, you know, the United Kingdom with the Brexit vote. It's a response to a crisis of capitalism. I try to remind people of this very often, and it's very hard to hear that if you are within the United States, because we tend to simplify, Americans tend to simplify everything into its direct aesthetic. The white nationalists hate black people. They hate Jews. They hate queers. They hate Muslims, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And that all of that is absolutely 100% true. But they are also being affected by the same thing that is affecting movements like ISIS or ISIL, the Islamic State. There is a collapse coming. It's being triggered partially by our dwindling resources. But primarily, you know, through the framework of capitalism, capital cannot continue to expand without these really sharp contractions. But no one wants to lose their current access to resources. And that goes equally for the rich in the United States as it goes for the poor. You know, if as long as the United States has been able to keep grocery stores and massive box stores full of products that you can buy, as long as there's a new iPhone, as long as you could get a new flat screen television, then everybody in the United States will have the sense that at least capitalism is continuing. Things are going along this one path. Even if you cannot afford it, you still have the sense that humanity is doing something, that the government and the entire system works. It just doesn't necessarily work for you. The increase in violence against blacks and indigenous folk in the United States, the increase in violence against immigrants, and the increase in anger and resentment from poor and middle class whites is all simultaneously reaction to the fact that capitalism is crumbling. We can't point to one thing here, one thing there, and say, hey, you know, hey, look, this is proof, but the system is grinding to a halt.
Yeah.
And whenever it hits crisis moments like this, racism, ethno-nationalism, and all of these other really simplistic and violent ideologies are what people run to. They run to anything fundamentalist. The grass is the first thing that they can come up to. You know, you're having a really bad day, and then suddenly, you know, you find out you're losing your job, and you also just lost your lease on your apartment. Oh, fuck, it's the Jews. You know, it's absurd, but people grasp for the closest thing that they can find. And that's what's happening in the United States. And, you know, the same thing is happening in France, where this permanently. But when we're trying to fight fascism and trying to fight white nationalists, we need to be clear on why we're fighting them. And I've seen this a lot in, even in the anti-fascist movement itself, where there's a sense that one is fighting the right because people want to protect America and make it safe and tolerant again. It's never been safe and tolerant ever. It has for some whites, but it's never been for blacks. It's never been for indigenous people. It's never been for immigrants. When we're attempting to fight fascism in whatever form, I mean, you know, as far as I'm concerned, you know, punch the fuck out of them. But be clear that punching them is not going to stop the empire from falling.
Yeah.
And right now, I think probably all of these movements are kind of hitting a moment where they realize this is just going to increase. Like, how do you stop the rise of fascism? You really don't. But if you see the fascists as competitors for the seat of power, as it were, of the American Empire. You know, they're trying to rush the throne right now at the same time that the Democratic Party is trying to rush the throne at the same time as everyone else is. But someone's going to sit on that throne unless we destroy the throne. And right. And I think as an anarchist particularly, that's always been a major frustration when talking to American anarchists, because especially the white urban ones, they don't really quite grasp that, you know, the days of being able to get a latte every morning are going away, and they need to go away.
You know,
no one wants to lose that. We just want to fight Nazis, and it's like, well, yeah. But we're also going to lose this. And so what does that mean? What kind of world are we going to build instead?
Right.